The IFS function is a new Excel function that is available in Office 365 and Excel 2019. The IFS function lets you specify multiple if conditions within one function call. It replaces the old method of nesting multiple if functions and lets you enter up to 127 conditions, so your formula should be easier to read and understand. The only downside to this function is that you can't specify an else condition. But not to worry, we have a workaround that we'll show you later in this video. So let's get started by looking at an example of how to use the IFS function. Here we have a table of data that consists of a list of items. Let's use the IFS function to return a different value depending on the item. Let's begin by entering the IFS command. As you can see, the IFS function takes condition return value pairs. This requires you to enter one parameter for the condition to test for and a second parameter for the value to return when the condition is true. You can enter up to 127 of these pairs. So let's enter our first condition return value pair. We'll enter A2 equals apple as the condition and fruit as the return value. What this means is that if the value in cell A2 is equal to apple, the IFS function will return the value fruit. For our next pair, we will enter A2 equals potato as the condition and veg as the return value. In the second pair, when the value in cell A2 is equal to potato, the IFS function will return veg. Now for our third pair, we will enter A2 equals steak as the condition and meat as the return value. Let's complete the command to see what results we get. You should see the value fruit appear in cell C2. Since cell A2 is equal to apple, the IFS function will return a value of fruit. Now let's copy our formula into cells C3 to C5. Now we have the return value of veg in cell C3 and a return value of meat in cell C4. Notice that in cell C5 we have a return value of pound NA. This value was returned because none of the conditions evaluated to true in our IFS formula. Normally we would include an else condition to handle this case and prevent the formula from returning the pound NA error. But since the IFS function doesn't have an else parameter, we've come up with an easy workaround. So let's rewrite our formula in column D to include our else condition. The formula will begin the same as the original formula with our three condition return value pairs as follows. Now to avoid getting the pound NA error, we'll create one final condition return value pair at the end of the formula. We'll enter true as the condition and miscellaneous as the return value. Since the Boolean value true is always true, once the IFS function reaches this condition, it will evaluate to true and return the miscellaneous value. Now let's copy our formula down into cell D3 to D5. This time we can see that instead of returning the pound NA for coffee, the IFS function has returned the value miscellaneous in cell D5. Our else condition has worked. This completes our example of how to use Excel's IFS function. If you would like to see more examples or would like to download the sample data we used for this tutorial, please visit our website at techonthenet.com. If you found our tutorial helpful, please leave a like on this video and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more great Excel tutorials.